So, good morning. Today we're out in the forest. A bit less noise, or at least a different kind of noise than my last video. And yeah, my last video was pretty popular and I got a lot of positive comments. A lot of people liked it. So I thought, why not do another one? Today I'm out in a very small forest close to where I live. This forest, you can probably walk straight through it in around 15-20 minutes. So it's a very small forest. I almost always go out to photograph just like 5 minute walk from where I live, because as a dad of two small children, I usually do not have the time to be away for more than a couple of hours at a time. But that works pretty fine anyway. And that's something I really like about macro photography, that you don't need to travel anywhere. You can find interesting photos wherever you are. Here we have an ant. Pretty quick one. Today I'm using the setup that I think I like the most, or at least the one that I have been using the most since I started with macro photography, and that is Sony a7 III, Lauva 60mm macro lens, and the Mikey MK320 flash. And then I have this diffuser, which is of the brand Dörr. This diffuser is not sold everywhere in the world, so you might need to find a diffuser of a different brand, but there are similar ones you can buy. I will put some links in the description of this video. Here we have some kind of bug. Wait, I'm gonna get this mosquito here. Ah! I felt the sting. If you're out photographing in a forest like this, I think it can be a good idea to look close to places where there is water. Here we have some water, and I notice already that I find more insects around here. Here we have some blueberries. Not really finished yet though. See a little bug here. I'm gonna try to pluck the leaf. These bugs usually don't make for very nice photos, but I can't resist trying. trying to put him back approximately where I picked him up. There are so many mosquitoes. Can't stand still for too long. Here we have another one who is a bit more active. Maybe. I like when they sit on a branch like this, makes the photo a bit more interesting. And if there are leaves close by in the background, that can often be a very good thing because you get a more greenish, interesting background and not black. That is because the flash bounces against the leaf in the background. So I try to place it in right behind the bug. Okay. Oh, here we have a leaf hopper, a bit bigger one. But he doesn't want to be in the picture. Or does he? Oof. Mosquitoes. Hey, please. Alright, I'll leave him alone. I think I got one good photo. Maybe. If it was sharp. Oh, what's this? Tiny, tiny little bug. If you wonder why I shake my head violently now and then, it's because a mosquito tries to land on me. Sorry about that. I'm finding a lot of insects here close to the water. Here we have a fly or something. I wonder if he's asleep. Let's try to get a shot. Oh, lost him. Flew away. Well, you learn something new every time you're out. Today I learned that I need to get some repellent against mosquitoes if I'm out early in the morning in the forest. That was definitely a big mistake that I did not bring that. If you have tips about good products for that, let me know in the comments. Oh, I thought it was an insect, it was just dust. What's this? Ah, not that interesting, I think. Trying to fit the focal plane with the fly's body. Ah, too many mosquitoes. Oh, What's this? Is it like a bigger leafhopper? This one is so hard to photograph when there are so many mosquitoes. Did I get the good one? No, need to go back. Now where was he? Here. Let's check again. There, I nailed it. I really like this shot. Probably my favorite today. If you know the species, please let me know in the comments. And that goes for all the insects in this video. As you may have noticed, I don't change my settings that much. I go with the standard settings I mostly recommend people as a baseline, unless I see a good reason to change, and that's 1/250th of a second in shutter speed, ISO 100 or as low as your camera can go, flash at 1/16th and aperture f8. And those are really good settings. It's hard to not take good photos with them. And of course I have both the camera and the flash in manual mode, so that I always know that I will get the same exposure every time. This looks like a small brown leafhopper. Background too black. Let's try with a leaf in the background again. This is actually the first photo work I deliberately try to do this. Earlier it has been by coincidence. Leaf has to be some distance away though, for it to look good. Like 5-10 centimeters. Problem there is that my fingers are there as well, giving a pink color that I don't like. It doesn't look very natural. This is hard. Maybe like this. Where is he? Maybe this can probably look a bit better when I adjust it in Lightroom a bit to brighten the background. We'll see. Did not look great in camera though. If you guys have any tips on good mosquito repellents that are really effective for you, please let me know in the comments. Oh, is that a jumping spider? Think so. At least by the movement pattern. No, it wasn't. What the hell is this? Am I at maximum magnification? Yes. Where did you go? Whoops. I don't think jumping spiders have that long antennas. But it kind of moves like a jumping spider. Short sprints like that. Hey, can I get a photo, please? Very fast guy. If you know what this is, please let me know in the comments. I hope I got a sharp photo because it looks like I'm not gonna get another photo of this guy. It's too fast. Maybe I should just chill for a while and let him calm down. Lost track of him. Well, oh, there he is. No, I'm not even gonna attempt. He's too quick. Just wasted time, probably. Another one of those small, I think it's a leafhopper. It's interesting with all the different motivations people have for doing their photography, and especially for macro photography. Some people seem to be mostly interested in the insects themselves and are looking to photograph interesting species and stuff like that. But for me, yeah, of course it's fun to find an insect that you haven't found before and then photograph it, but for me the whole like pursuit and what I love about macro photography is trying to take a good looking photograph. And it doesn't matter if it's a very unusual insect or if it's a normal fly, if I can make the photo look aesthetically pleasing with a nice color contrast, nice background and interesting angle and all of that to make it a really interesting photo. That is what I'm after. Here we have a yellowish fly. Let's see if we can hopefully get it. Cannot find it in the viewfinder. The mosquitoes are killing me, and now we flew away. Well, well. Do you see how much mosquitoes it is here? It's like a swarm. Take a few steps this direction. If you are a regular follower of this channel and you still haven't signed up to my monthly inspiration newsletter, Please consider doing so. It's only once a month and it's free, and it's filled with inspiration and tips about great macro photographers that I found, and yeah, just a nice thing to get in your inbox once a month. Go sign up if you're interested. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, if you like this kind of content. I make new videos about macro photography at least once per week. Try to do it 2 times per week. Oh, here we have... Oh, too much mosquitoes here. We have a nice looking beetle. Ah. Now we got scared. Okay. Yeah, sometimes you're not lucky. Alright guys, I think that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, I've had enough mosquito bites by now, I think, so I'm gonna go home. Yeah, see you next week again, or maybe even sooner. Over and out. Bye bye.